Hello. In this class, we will look at into the cell wall of bacteria. Okay. So this is a bacteria is divided into gram positive and gram negative based upon the staining. That is the gram staining. So with the gram staining property, you can differentiate bacteria into gram positive and gram negative. This is a image of a gram positive bacteria. The downside, I will try to show the image of a gram negative bacteria. Okay. Here, you try to locate where the cell wall is present. This is cell membrane. Okay. Cell wall is present outside to the cell membrane. So, this is cell wall. Okay. So, it is a mesh-like structure that have been present outside to the cell membrane is cell wall. This cell wall is referred by the name murine sacculus or peptidoglycan or cell envelope. These are the analogous terms they will use to denote about the cell wall of the bacteria. So this cell wall is more denser or more thicker than the gram-positive organism. However, if you look at the cell wall arrangement there in the gram-negative bacteria, they found to have a very thin layer of peptidoglycan or cell wall. Apart from that, they have an outer membrane. This one is referred as outer membrane. This outer membrane is a lipopolysaccharide in nature. This is present mainly in the gram-negative bacteria. So here also you can see downside to the cell wall is a cell membrane of the bacteria. We will go into detail of the cell wall here in this image. So here, this is the one shows the cell wall of a gram positive, gram negative, and a RKA also. Okay. So if you look at the first one is a gram positive. Example for a gram positive organism is Bacillus. Bacillus is an example for a gram-positive bacteria. So, this is the cell wall of the gram-positive bacteria. This one is the cell wall of the gram-negative bacteria. You can able to see the outer membrane, which is made up of lipopolysaccharide there. And you can able to see a thin layer of peptidoglycan there. The example for a gram-negative bacteria is Pseudomonas. And then we come into the third one. Third one is an archaea. Bacteria, the living organism in this world are divided into three groups. That is bacteria, archaea and eukaryotes. So this is the one we have seen in the first unit. Differences between the bacteria and archaea and eukaryotes. Those things we have narrated as a comparative account. Okay. So here this is a archaea. RKL cell wall has been shown here. The RKL cell wall is commonly referred by the term pseudopeptidoglycan. It is referred by this term pseudopeptidoglycan, or it is also called as a pseudomurine. Whereas the bacterial thing is referred as a murine. There will be some small differences are all there. Those things we will try to look at now. If you look at there into the gram positive bacteria, you can able to see a very thin layer of peptidoglycan there. Okay. So this is a thin layer of the peptidoglycan there. So this peptidoglycan, apart from that, they will be having a lot of other glycoprotein and other things. Okay. So this is a cell wall peptidoglycan, which is in turn made up of two monomeric subunits. One is N-acetyl glucosamine and another one is N-acetyl muramic acid. So peptidoglycan is in turn made up of two monomeric subunits. One is N-acetyl glucosamine, which is referred as a NAG, and N-acetyl muramic acid, which is referred as a NAM, NAM. Then if you come into gram-negative bacteria, the same monomeric units are making into the peptidoglycan. In the structural arrangement of the peptidoglycan between the gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, there is no much difference. Only the amount or thickness of the peptidoglycan is more there in the gram positive compared to that of the gram negative. Whereas both the things will be sharing the same monomeric subunits, and both are linked again by same type of linkage, that is beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. Now we will come into the third group, that is archaea. Archaea, as I already told, it is referred by the term pseudoburine or pseudopeptidoglycan. This pseudoburine or pseudopeptidoglycan is in turn made up of two monomeric subunits. One is common for the gram-positive and gram-negative, that is N-acetylglucosamine. However, N-acetylmuramic acid is not present commonly in the archaea. It has been replaced with N-acetyl-thallosaminouranic acid. You note down the red thing there. So N-acetyl-thallosaminouranic acid. Apart from that, the archaeal cell wall will have some crystalline layer there on the surface. Sometimes they found to have a crystalline layer present there, or a glycoprotein present there on the surface of the cell wall. Another difference there between the gram-positive, gram-negative, and archaeal cell wall is the type of linkage in which these monomeric units have been bounded. There it is beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage, whereas here it is beta-1,3 glycosidic linkage. So that is the linkage with which these monomeric molecules have been bounded there in the peptidoglycan. Now we will look it out how the cross-linking has been established there on the bacterial cell wall. So this one is a gram-positive cell wall and this one is a gram-negative cell wall. So this, the blue color ringed structure is a N-acetylmuramic acid. The red color ringed structure is a N-acetylglucosamine. They will be just a repetitive unit of a beta-1,4 glycosidic linkages, whereas it is of a 1,3 linkage there in the archaea. Okay, here this linkage is of a 1,3 type there in the archaea. If you look at here, each N-acetyl muramic acid found to have a lot of different side chains. Okay, these side chains are actually made up of the following amino acids. First one is a L-alanine, second one is a D-glutamate, third one is a L-lysine, and fourth one is a D-alanine. That is, four different peptides or four different amino acids will be attached there. A peculiar point here you need to note is, commonly L amino acids will be dominating there in the living organisms. However, only in the bacterial cell wall as well as in the antibiotics produced by bacteria, you can see the amino acids that are all with a D configuration. Dextrorotatory type configuration of amino acids are common here there in the cell wall that is attached there to the N-acetylmuramic acid. Okay. If you look at there again, this is a gram negative. Here also you can able to see a different L as well as D configured side chains that are made up of amino acids have been present here. Here, how a parallel peptidoglycan chains have been linked is shown here. Here the linkage is of a pentaglycine linkage. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 glycine will be present there. How it will be present? If you look at here, you can able to understand. So this is one N-acetylmuramic acid that is having the four side chains, four amino acids that have been present there in the side chain. So this has been attached to the other parallel peptidoglycan chain by a pentaglycine, which is also called as a peptide interbridge. Whereas if you look at there into the other group, that is in the gram positive, sorry, in the gram negative bacteria, the linkage is direct. It is called as a direct cross-link that has been established with the third amino acid of one N-acetylmuramic acid with the fourth amino acid of the parallel N-acetylmuramic acid. With that, it will be forming a direct cross-link by which the mesh-like arrangement of the peptidoglycan will be maintained there. Okay, now we look at the structure of the archaeal cell wall, that is pseudomurine. or pseudopeptidoglycan. It is made up of N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl talosaminouranic acid. Okay. Example for a archaea is Methanobacterium. It's an example for the archaea. Here, the linkage between the adjacent monomers of this polymeric pseudomurine is made up of beta-1,3 linkage, whereas that is beta-1,4 linkage. We now look at some more important details that have been present there in the cell wall of the bacteria. So one chain has been shown here. This is the other chain. It is named as a glycan chain. That is a glycan chain A. This is the other one is a glycan chain B. You can able to see the N-acetyl glucosamine, N-acetyl muramic acid. So repetitive units have been present there. Okay. The backbone of peptidoglycan is always consists of amino sugars, that is N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muramic acid, that are bonded by beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. This is called as a beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. Here, this linkage is the one which can be broken well with an enzyme called as a lysozyme. This lysozyme is an enzyme which is commonly present in the saliva, even in the human eyes, tears which we coming out from the eyes. They also found to have a lot of lysozyme. This lysozyme has the ability to kill the bacteria that have been colonizing there in the eye region. If a bacterial infection is happening, that bacteria can be even naturally evaded with the help of the lysozyme that have been present there in the tears. Then the other point, peptide crosslinks hold together the glycan chains. Okay. These are all some more points. Pentaglycine linkage, which I have already explained. Now we look at one more point related with the pentaglycine linkage. So this pentaglycine linkage is the one which is commonly come across there in the peptidoglycan of gram-positive bacteria. So these gram-positive bacteria's peptidoglycan containing pentaglycine linkage can be hydrolyzed there with the help of the penicillin. The mechanism is penicillin can prevent the transpeptidation reaction that is taking place between this pentaglycine linkage.